Okay, welcome everybody to this Inside Real Estate weekly webinar. This is our usual add-ons and extensions time slot. So what we're doing today is some tactics for teams and team leaders. We have a lot of teams using KB Core Conversion Plus, and we don't often talk about things from the team perspective on these webinars. So this will be a nice change. We have a guest today, Roberto Lara. Roberto, are you a teams consultant? What's your title?
My title is the core team coordinator. So basically, I'm here to help any team leader who's considering the team platform understand the value behind it, the mechanics of it, basically anything at all, you know, get people's questions answered and help them connect with, you know, whoever on this end can get, you know, their questions, concerns addressed. And I do, you know, one-on-one demonstrations of kind of the team solution, so I can kind of dig into, you know, different teams have different formats, they have different goals, they have different, you know, approaches to the business. And so understanding, you know, how this might be adapted to their business is something that I can absolutely address with anybody who's interested in a one-on-one format. And we'll talk today about how they can schedule into my calendar to spend some time and discuss that.
Okay.
And I can kind of get a little bit of my background. I've been consulting brokerages, agents, teams on internet marketing for about 16 years. And next month will be a year with Inside Real Estate.
Cool. Yep. So what I thought we'd do today, we'll go through some tactics. I threw down some bullet points. You can chime in, Roberto, talk about some things that maybe team leaders are already doing, or maybe they might try out, especially, you know, as they use this powerful software to have their hands on. And then we'll do a little bit of talk specifically about the team add-on after that content. Okay, can everybody see my screen? I think you can, Roberto. Just somebody let
yes.
me know. I assume everybody can hear us, and we'll just kind of go ahead and. So one of the first bullet point I have here, and this is an idea that I've talked about a handful of times, but I don't often see people do, and that is to give everybody on your team a niche focus. So, you know, there's buyer agents and listing agents and, you know, going back to Keller's book about having those roles within the millionaire agent, you know, team. But there's not a lot of talk about, hey, you know, when you talk to a buyer's agent on your team, like, what's your thing? Are you going to work with investors? Are you going to do new construction? Are you going to do condos? And I think that kind of niching, you know, KB Core in particular and conversion, they lend themselves nicely to that, because of the tools we have our hands on. So we have our lead drop box, so you can capture leads from any other source if you're using third-party solutions to get leads, right? I think everybody knows we have that. But the big feature here might be something like the landing and squeeze pages that we can do. Roberto, have you seen people doing this? Is it something that you've explored?
I mean, it's actually something that I previous to this role, I was selling KV Core to, you know, the larger brokerages, what have you. And it's definitely something that I would impress upon, you know, brokers that we teach their agents how to use that squeeze page, because it can be such a powerful source of free leads if, you know, if deployed correctly. And you know, a team can be made up of a bunch of different agents, like you say, each maybe with their own defined niche, or at least ideas of, you know, what are they into? You know, are they into, you know, into horses? Are they into sports? Are they into, you name it? And there's a way to, you know, target what I'd say personas on Facebook using especially the squeeze pages, and direct them to properties that might be of interest to them, capture them and get them in their database.
Yeah, so kind of what we're talking about is you would take the different buyer agents or players on your team and say, hey, what kind of deal do you like doing? And if somebody says, I love working with investors, you can go into our landing page creator or the squeeze page generator. Both will do this in a similar way, as Roberto says. And you can help them create a page like this that says something like, you know, free weekly list of cash flowing income properties. I'm doing this fast, income properties in Tampa, Florida. And you can then, you know, once you've got the idea, once you've got this set up, that teammate of yours, you can say, all right, now your job, right, is to every day get out there on Facebook, get out there on Twitter, get out there, whatever the sources might be, get on Craigslist, and make sure you're sending as many people as possible through this page, through this funnel. And coach them, of course, along the way on what goes into this. You know, if it's a newbie agent, they don't know a lot about investment properties, but they want to know, then you'll help them there. But from the tech side, you have tools that'll let you build out these niche funnels. And also you have the ability to order traffic or send paid traffic, PPC, through our advertising services. So what are some of the cool niches you've seen, Robert? I don't mean to put you on the spot, but.
No, by all means. So this I actually learned from my director, Brian, and this was, I thought, a really cool strategy is first you create a squeeze page where you target all the properties that are just, say, right around, in his case, he'd always use, the sports team, wherever the big sports team plays, you can go and you can literally draw a circle or do a high walking score to that location. You could also do reduced. You could limit it to just condos, and you can go into Facebook, join all these groups, many of them which have tens of thousands of people, and say whatever Dodger fans. Want to have a condo walking distance to the ballpark? Check out all the reduced price condos, walking distance to the ballpark. That's just one I thought really good idea. He uses the example of the Raiders in Las Vegas, because I guess they're now establishing their new home base there. But it translates into, any major sports teams. If you're, if you're in the South, obviously, you've got the college ball is huge, and having a place nearby, a sports location, but there's lots of others. Golf course homes is already a selected option therein, and you've also got people that are into equestrian, riding horses, and that's already an option right there in the drop down menu. For investors like you're pointing out there, there's multi-unit properties you can filter by, or fixer uppers, or kind of a combination of the two.
I'll show everybody up on the screen. I think most of the people here kind of seen the squeeze builder, but we have this new polygon feature that Roberto just alluded to, where you could go straight on, draw on the map, and you can pick, you can go to the stadium on the map and literally draw a 1 mile or 2 mile radius right around the stadium, and offer, designate that your buyer agent is the guy who serves New York Giants fans, right? That's what he's about. I hope you live close to East Rutherford or whatever it is, within 10 miles of the Meadowlands. So definitely. So this tool, within everybody on your team should be using this. And one step you can take as a team leader, getting back to the topic here, is to help your buyer's agents identify what those niches are for them and help them execute on the tech side of things, creating these pages and getting traffic to the pages. So yeah, I love that one, Roberto, thank you. Now, another thing here, just to mention with these pages, you may or may not already know, you have the ability with the sourcing and the hashtags as you build them to build routing rules around them. So if my source is New York Giants Stadium, right? You can then go into the lead routing rules, KV Core, where it says lead routing here, and you can route based on that source to that specific agent or subset of agents, depending on what the niche would be. So just to kind of show you on the screen what we're talking about, right? And then you can set your rules here. So very powerful stuff, all the way from the front to the back of the funnel with squeeze pages. Anybody have any questions yet? Me and Roberto are just kind of talking here and nobody said anything. So I always like to check in, make sure everybody's good. If you have any niches that you work or that we didn't mention that you think are cool, let us know. If you have a team and you're not already doing this but think it's a good idea, let us know. It shows you have a pulse. We appreciate it. All right.
And I'm happy to go, and brainstorm with anyone, that wants to get in my calendar and spend some time, talk about what their specific, niche might be. And you know, craft a way that that squeeze page and maybe a landing page could be formulated to, you know, effectively target that niche.
Yeah, and we have a few old webinars. We'll get into the document here too around landing pages and niches that will include. So that's one big team tactic. Niche everybody down if you can. If you're trying to look for ways to get more business or to keep your, let's call it, provide value to the buyer agents on your team. Let's face it, a lot of times if you're a team leader, that buyer agent's getting a little bit of a smaller split, right? They're sharing, they're paying you more or less for the lead flow and to be the rainmaker. So you can provide a little extra value here by helping them set up their system around a specific niche. Okay, next thing, we kind of talked about this on yesterday's webinar, Roberto, is the business analytics feature. And what I have here is use KV Core business analytics to reward or scale up leads for higher performing buyer agents. And the flip side of that is to take lead flow away from the ones who aren't performing, right? So, yeah. I'll kind of just give a sneak peek at that here. And I think this is, you know, it's a relatively new feature. I think this is one that doesn't get used enough. We talked about it on yesterday's tracking webinar. You can see the replay of that at insiderealestate.com/replays. We have all our replays there. But basically, you can go in and you can look quickly at agent performance on the business analytics page. And you can see, this is a demo account, so everything doesn't look so great, but you can see, you know, percentage of new lead calls completed, percentage of tasks completed, things like that, just at a really quick glance. So as I mentioned yesterday, you know, schedule a weekly appointment with yourself to just review what the agents on your team are doing, and then adjust the lead routing rules that you have going to your team accordingly. Any other thoughts on business analytics, Roberto?
Offhand, I mean, it's just a great spot to get, you know, just a bird's eye view of your business writ large. I always point out to my clients how, you know, the importance of the source performance as a means of sort of understanding where to target your marketing dollars. You know, you try something new, you try, you know, whether it is Realtor.com or Zillow or maybe even some, you know, lesser, more obscure lead source, of which there's a lot out there, and KV Core is really powerful in that you can tie any of them in. But we want to know, is this worth pursuing any further, or is this not yielding the results that we want? And being able to see your business like this, you know, by source, and then how many of those leads turned into which statuses, can really help guide a team leader and maybe their support staff in figuring out where to best allocate their marketing dollars moving forward.
Yeah, and to our last point, it'll also help you know which niches are really working. So, you know, maybe you got a buyer agent who's doing that investor thing, and you find out that that's not really working as well as the guy who's selling homes to the New York Giants fans, and maybe you throw some more resources at the New York Giants fan idea right there. Cool. So definitely use business analytics to get insight on how your team is doing. I snuck in here. Let's see here. Use Property Boost to close more listings and justify more price reductions. This is kind of for everybody, not just teams. But in terms of a quick way to get leads flowing to your team, I'm going to assume that anybody who has a team has some listing inventory. And if you want a quick, very affordable way to get leads flowing into your whole team, start advertising your listings with Property Boost. We have separate webinars about that and a tile in the marketplace, which is a really wonderful way to not only close more listings, but juice that lead flow. What have you seen? Have you seen anything with Property Boost in your people? I know it's pretty young.
You know, that's a pretty fresh thing, but I've just kind of taken your cue as far as I know in another conversation you mentioned that it's one of our very best performers in a cost per lead stance. Is that right?
Yeah, from a cost per lead stance and the leverage you get, because not only are you generating the leads around specific listings, but you're in automatic communication with your sellers. And you're gathering data that will help you get price reductions. So I just love the thing. I always gush when it comes up. So and I'll add in here, use Facebook buyer ads, Google buyer PPC, and Property Boost. And this more speaks to just using the off-the-shelf marketplace add-ons that we have in order to get more leads flowing to your team with the click of a button. I'm always surprised some people don't realize that those options are available or what they entail. So just keep those in mind if you need to kind of feed your team with leads. Okay, here's another one, Roberto. I think you know Shane, right, who works with us?
Absolutely.
So recently, Shane and I were playing around, and there's this idea of retargeting that you may or may not have heard of where, you know, you visit a website, and then the stuff that was on that website starts to follow you around. Amazon, Walmart, they're all doing this. My buddy and my wife, we were just talking about how, you know, you can't even say anything near your phone these days because you'll see an ad about what you were talking about. really, really creepy stuff, right? But basically, we can use this to our advantage, and especially for teams who are trying to build a brand presence around your team name. You know, you're under this brokerage. The brokerage has their brand presence, but as a team leader, if you want to start to seem like you're everywhere, retargeting can be a powerful thing. So what I want to show on the screen here was just an example of a thank you video that Shane, who works at Inside Real Estate, did as a demo. And we were showing to the leads coming to his site, to the traffic coming to his site. And I know what's going on. Let me just get another browser window here. I'm using the Brave browser, which is like a ad blocker deal.
Oh yeah, I just downloaded that on my home computer.
Crypto-based ad blocker deal.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think it was with my ability to sway that page. Here we go. I'm so conflicted with Brave because I literally run ads for a living, but love crypto. So it's like I get really dizzy using that thing.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
All right. So the ad reads, "Thanks for visiting SoCal Home Locator recently. Feel free to call or text me anytime." It has his contact info and his name. And you know, this, just imagine this with your team name. You know, team, there's different rules around naming teams in different states, but if your team was the Lara team or something, you would have this fan page with that branding. Then you as the team leader would be in this video as Shane is doing.
Hi, Shane Capriano here with Big Block Realty. Just want to thank you for registering on.
And all he does is he just says, "Hey, thanks. You're on my website the other day. If you need to get a hold of me, here's how to get a hold of me. My cell number's right there." And we make a little extra deal right here. Click after this video ends to see a complete current list of off-market SoCal homes now, right? Just a little bit of extra juice. So basically what you can do with KV Core is take or conversion is drop your retargeting pixels into the system. Trying to get my window, and start to show these kinds of ads to the people visiting that help build your brand and convert more of your leads. And one bullet point I didn't have here, we have a course. I've created a course in the learning portal, which is accessible from the bottom left here, that'll show you how to pull that off. It's called Retargeting 101, and this specific thank you video is also in the Facebook ads course. So if you go to all courses here, it'll be kind of buried right now. We're gonna make this a little better, but we have the generating and converting real estate leads for paid Facebook ads. I have a whole tutorial in there about the approach we took through Shane, and then the general retargeting course is here somewhere, Real Estate Retargeting 101. And as I mentioned this, you know, another thing you could do is have your whole team make sure they're plugged in and using this stuff in the learning portal and getting trained, you know, by the people here at Insight. Right there. So, oh, wow. I just looked up. There's a bunch of questions, and Annalisa, you're doing wonderful at answering them. Thank you. So,
I'm here for you, caller. I'm here for you. And I do believe Brian is on his way to join us as well.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Cool. All right.
I'm on the call. I'm listening in. So nice day, everybody.
Hey, Brian.
So I'm just listening in. So I'll comment. But we have retargeting for all the teams here. Is super effective. I like to look at it as it's an opportunity. It's like the real estate book. The more they see you out there and things that you do and billboards, it's just a better way of doing that type of marketing. And you know, that it's always effective. It's just a mindshare awareness. And this is just a better way to do it at a lot less money than a big billboard on the side of the freeway.
Yeah, good point. I have the screenshot here. I'll try to make it big for everybody, Brian. You know, this ran, I think, over a few weeks, I think about $60 was spent at $5 a day. And it got 143 through plays. It generated a bunch of clicks back to the site, but 605 people saw the video. you know, and that's just, this is actually a little expensive as far as Facebook's concerned, because, but it was a very small sample, not a lot of traffic going to that particular site of Shane's. But it just shows, you know, without him doing anything, he's talking to 605 people who are on his site. They're seeing his branding in the fan page. And the cost to do this, it's 47 cents to get somebody to watch the video through Play.
So. Exactly. And when you think of Shane and guys, everybody listening in, he's not a heavy team. Teams that are heavy duty teams that have thousands of leads and these types of things. This is a very inexpensive way. Don't use drip emails and all this kind of stuff that annoy people. This is an easy way to really get a message out and a way to stay in front of people in a much more productive way with a lot more value.
Yep. And I will note that, you know, we have the courses that show you how to do this. We are talking a lot about delivering this as a done for you service. So we'll probably hear about that hopefully in the next few months. I don't want to make any promises, but it's coming. So as a done for you, but it's pretty easy to set up. There's plenty of people out there who can help you set it up, or just follow the instructions and do it yourself. Next big one, I'll let you two talk about this. Brian, I know you have experience here. I have a lot of experience here. Lender co-marketing.
So there's always a, absolutely, there's a misconception on this idea is that lenders are more, are getting less and less intrigued by this because of RESPA and the things that have been happening. But the reality of it is it's just equal value to both parties. So the lender plays a critical role in this. What that means is that a lender can set up to 50% of your marketing and your platform expense. They have to be billed through us, and they can't exceed that. Now, the most important thing, though, is it's co-value. What's missing in all of this is that it's not buy a bunch of leads on Zillow, because those leads don't have value to the lender unless you're closing them. They want transactions. You want their money to help get more opportunity to send more transactions to them. So let's just get to the nitty-gritty, Ryan, on this when I explain this to agents. This is the bottom line. When you're going with lenders, that lender wants your referral business. When you refer business to an agent, Ryan, you get a commission, you get a check back. They can pay you a referral fee, right, Ryan?
Right. It's RESPA
when you
cool.
Refer. Right, which is great. But when you refer that business to a lender, they can't give you money back. It's illegal. So in a sense, as an agent, it's just the ability for the lender to refer money back to you for giving them referrals. All the marketing, all the advertising, all the stuff in between, that's what this is a way for you to use their money to help give them more referrals and do it legally through a compliance, a RESPA compliance site. We make that possible through the way that we advertise them throughout the system. The second go ahead.
I feel bad for the lenders hearing this. So that's what the lenders, it's really cool the way you said that, because a lot of lenders out there is like, well, I'm not getting any benefit from this. All the agent wants is my money. And there is a middle ground.
Agents go into this thing, have five lenders, and all they want is the lender's money, and they're giving them leads that aren't going to close right away for the lender. So the agent doesn't get the referral business over. And then also most of the platforms out there, and I want everybody to hear this because this is really important, don't empower the individual agent with lead gen like our system. So all they're getting is the referral leads from the broker that go to the agents, and the agents don't necessarily don't have hyperactive agents that follow up. So there's not a lot of leads and individual connection to the actual agent. It's all the relationship between the team agent, the agent itself, and the lender, not the team leader. The referral business has to be a collective, kind of like a car dealership. You have an in-house lender there. It's the same relationship. He's not out on the in-house lender's not out on the lot interviewing people. Okay. So the reality of this is it's a symbiotic relationship to get a deal done. The second part of this, because this is really, truly important, is by taking the leads off the table, you get happier lenders that want to contribute more. They don't want to buy the leads, so they're reluctant to do it. But if you make it about the relationship and the referral business, they're more likely to contribute and stay happy.
Yeah,
the last thing that's – does that make sense?
Yeah, go ahead.
And the last thing that's important is that the lender has to be an integral part of the nurture process. That means having a script and communication between you and the agents that tees up things to the lender, because you can't get a deal done without the lender. So the more that you get the person referred over to the lender earlier in the process, the better off you are at getting more deals. You have to make them integral and part of the process. So for example, you might do a marketing plan, Ryan, around the special loan programs for teachers. And then, well, the lender has the special loan program. So they're, you're marketing and generating a bunch of teacher leads on Facebook for nothing, but they're, you're sharing them with the lender who's part of the process and knows to reach out about the special loan program. And you're creating an ecosystem of value. And a lot of times what we end up doing is get money by pay-per-click. And we do not create an ecosystem where the lender and the team leader and teams are working together in a cohesive value. This is actually really simple to do, especially with our system, but it has to think about how you're doing this. So that's just the important part about the lender relationship. And if you put a program together like this, they're always going to contribute. I've never had a lender say no, ever.
So you bring up some really good points. So, you know, I think it's important to not work with five different lenders. Find the one who's really serious, you know, and you are going to work as a team. And like you said, before you go spend money on the leads together, it's not so much about the leads. It's how are we going to work the leads together? So make sure that the system is in place.
Right.
And with KV Core, you've got smart campaigns. We have a lot of automation where you can add your lender's links and calls to action about calling for, you know, calling the lender or texting the lender into all that before the leads even get turned on. And if, you know, if you have all that set up already, it's going to be easier to pitch to the lender as well.
And that's actually part of the KV Core automation. A lot of that's already built in the campaigns that are in the system, Ryan. But the other thing that's also really cool about this when it comes to the relationship is that you have to have a cohesive script. So if you want to put down as a bullet point, I have my private script that I've done that's been very successful. There's teams that use it. It's in the KV Core dashboard right now under the learning portal, and it's titled Power Scripts and then the corrective statement. And the entire script is to get every lead, every conversation you make, instantly engaged into a proposal opportunity for your agents and hand them off to the lender. So it's very effective at teeing every lead. So it's not about intent to buy, because that's the thing that everybody misses about lead gen. It's not finding a lead that wants to buy now. It's that 30 to 40% of leads that can't buy, that could buy, but don't know better if you got them over to the lender. And so what we're kind of not doing that, and teams aren't doing that. And there's a specific script in here that allows for every agent, when they make a call, the majority of the calls they get into is in a productive conversation. So we can make another training on this if you'd like, Ryan, to go over this another time.
Yeah, scripts webinar would be great. So you said I didn't find it in the learning portal. Is it live in there yet?
It's in the support portal. We haven't done one. We should do one in the learning portal. Yes.
I just added the link to the training, and the video of which we recorded a little while back is also available within the body of that article. So
yeah, this is all outlined, and there's a video and there's a webinar on the scripts.
Yep.
Awesome. Cool. Okay, what do we have next? So lender, you know, get with a lender, work the system together. Don't make it just about getting money from your lender. Make sure you guys are partners, and everybody will be happier at the end of the day. But but this is a powerful way to not only double your lead generation budget, but also increase your conversion rates, because you're gonna have more parties working the leads as they come in.
And one other note, Ryan, if my budget's $2,000 as a team, and because we increased their budget by the low cost nature of our team add-on, it's saving teams anywhere from $500 on average to $1,200 a month, so saving $6,000 to $12,000 yearly that could be applied to marketing. But what it's really doing is also, as soon as you have a lender involved, it doubles your ROI instantly. So if half my budget's covered by my lender, my ROI goes, if it's 300% ROI, it's going to 600% instantly. So it literally doubles your ROI. That's the way to look at it. It doubles your profitability instantly.
So the last tactic before we get into a little bit more about the actual team add-on, it's something we touched on last week, was to use the WordPress plugin, the Agent Fire Spark site, some of the other design options we have in the marketplace, to unlock not only more branding specific to your team, but also some more content creation features. So we'll link to those specific webinars, but just know that it is possible to have a custom design branded to your team. Site.
Can I touch on that too, Ryan, real quick?
Yeah.
I get team after team after team that comes to me and says, I work for blank brokerage. and I want to do the team add-on, but I don't want to give my stuff. I want to have my own independence. I don't want to use the broker system. I want to stay private, right, Ryan? You hear this every, it's like the unsaid big barrier in all of this. What we're trying to do for you guys within KV Core is create an opportunity for you to go in and completely have an independent brand, an independent system, and not to pay thousands of dollars to go out and create something. And then you end up getting a jinky CRM that's a storage device. It isn't really up to speed. It's not the iPhone. It's like a flip phone. We want an integrated system. This allows you to create your own brand, your own individual team, your custom. You don't need to go out and get REW or some other competitor. And then the other team sites that most teams use, Ryan, the Boomtowns of the world, the Syncs of the world, they don't allow custom brands. It's just this landing page of lack of customization. So then they end up having to go out and spend all this money, and then it's a disconnect from reality. So within our platform, for everybody listening, when you want to go out and do a custom WordPress site, this is the only platform that has a fully integrated platform that's a plugin for WordPress. What that means is we are the only full service plugin for teams. So you can't go and recreate this. If you want to do a WordPress, we are the only system. Otherwise, you're going to get into a failure of a system where you have a plugin through iHome Finder that plugs in, and then a separate follow-up CRM that's not part of the ecosystem, and it's disconnected, and you have disconnected agents. So this is super important for teams to really look at this for that reason, because it's the only way possible, and it's completely branded, independent. It opens up all kinds of levels, and you can have it private, and the broker doesn't have access to your business. But it's all powered for a fraction of the cost.
Yeah, so we'll make sure we have the link. It's at insiderealestate.com/replays. We have the webinar last week with Agent Fire where we touched upon some of the specifics behind that. We also have the WordPress token that'll let you custom design your own site or hire a developer. But as Brian said, you know, you can put the any kind of front end you want on the front of this powerful KV Core backend.
Private and independent to you. So if you ever leave your company, your business, your brand, your product goes with you. There's no barrier. So there's no reason to be fearful that somehow you're giving your business over to your broker. You're just getting a discount.
We had a great question here. I'm just going to take a minute before we get into the next bullets. Can we do the same as with lenders, as with inspection companies or title companies? Brian, I'll let you, my first reaction is I don't see why not, just some issues maybe with routing the actual leads and how to
it
set
has
them
to
up.
Do with RESPA. So Brian, it has to do with RESPA. So it's not about whether you can promote them or receiving money. People think it's just about not paying for half. It's about equal value, Ryan.
Right.
So
right.
In other words, if I have a business card, on one side of the card is my business card and the other side of the card is fully about the inspector, I can do a 50-50 spin. The value is just not the same for the lender as it is for the inspector. So it's hard to calculate the equal or to receiving money. What you want to think about as inspectors is about exchanging of data, meaning that I want to promote them to my prospects, but I also provide value to my consumer, like a concierge service is what I like to tell teams to create with their partners. And by putting them into your concierge type service, that inspector then refers all of their business, and they're the ones that are more likely to refer leads to you as partners than lenders. So you partner with attorneys that do wills, and you partner with inspectors, and you partner with companies that do furniture or whatever it is. They're going to get, you know, I have a client that partners with divorce attorneys because their team, and they do a lot of business with that, because when you get a divorce, someone's selling a house. So they do a lot of work with them. So it's really thinking about these channels that aren't buying leads, because you don't want to be thinking about buying leads. You want to recreate channels that feed your business. And that's why you go after these types of third party users to create a concierge service to help feed your business. And that's what this is about. When you think about a hotel, they put people in their concierge service to drive business to local restaurants, because those local restaurants feed people back into their hotel. That's exactly the way that the real estate world should be working and thinking about this.
Great. So let's talk about the team add-on now specifically. So everything we said you know, anybody listening can use, whether or not, you know, I just want to get it out of the way. All the features, most of what we've talked about, you can put into practice in your business. But there's this team add-on that we have that Brian and Roberto, you know, specialize in. And I want to let you guys, I'm going to kind of hand it over and let you guys just talk about the why behind that and what's included.
Sure, no problem. So do you want to handle that, Bert, or do you want me to handle it?
I'll go ahead and start off. I mean, a lot of what I'm describing, I learned from Brian, and he kind of iterated this already, is that really when you get the team solution, it's like you came to us and said, hey, I'd like to get KV Core for my team, except that since you work for, you know, a broker who offers KV Core, you get an amazing discount on the system for your team. You're getting your own independent private system. It gives you a new level of administration that you know, you don't get when, if all of you are single individual users on your broker's platform, you just can't accomplish all the things that we're going to talk about today. Lead routing. And a big one that I get asked about a lot is lead ownership. I know it's one of the bullet points here under team management. It's that you make investment in all these leads for your team. And, you know, teams, you know, can wax and wane in size. People come, people go sometimes. And if someone leaves, you want to make sure that those leads that you invested in, maybe in, you know, in conjunction with your, you know, lender, third party or whomever, those are retained by the team. And that, I think, is a really big thing. Being able to kind of set the guardrails for the agents, being able to create team campaigns. So when your leads come in, your campaign dictates, you know, what's that first text message they get? What's that, you know, when are the calls scheduled for the agent? What tasks are scheduled? What do you want to have done with a lead? And then just let the system just set that out before the agent and automate those messages out to your leads, et cetera. And then finally, it's ability to, you know, generate, like we've already kind of described, generate your own brand and have that brand be inherited by the entire team. So their sites can, receive the same design. Their domain name now becomes a subdomain on your team domain name. And everybody's effectively on the same page. Just helps get everybody on the same page.
And normally what happens when teams go out and do this, Ryan, if you can just pull up that widget in the back office again that you do a circle around. Yeah. Normally what happens is they come to us every day. We get teams that come to us and say, I want to buy KV Core. How much is it? And so click on the actual get this button. And what happens is they go to other competitors that are out there, or they already have them, and they're paying, you know, $1,700-$1,800 a month for a, you know, Boomtown or some other competitor, or they're coming to us and they're saying, I want to buy it. And they got to spend over $1,000 a month as a team to buy it individually. But then they go, oh, well, I'm going to go work for such and such office. And they're the ones that told me about it. Instantly, they come right into here when they get access to their dashboard, they click a button and it's $399. So there's a huge discount that no one in the marketplace can match. The only barrier to this is, again, thinking that somehow this is going to be the company that they're using a company system. In reality, it's a separate custom site, customizable team site, team Dropbox, team landing pages, team smart number, customizable smart campaign, essentially their own private KV Core. They're just getting a discount. And so the reality is no long-term agreement. They have all the marketing issues. It's like Roberto said, they got their own system. If they ever leave the company,
there's no long-term
contract. No.
Wow.
After they leave the company, meaning if I decide to leave, and this happens, I can't tell you how many times, Ryan, a team gets recruited to a company. They come in, they get KV Core, and they're like, oh my God, I didn't know this is awesome. I'm going to start my own brokerage. And I've had a team do that. 3 days later, they start an independent brokerage with their 10 team because they got KV Core and they have the best broker system in the space. They just start their own office. They swap it out. They have to pay normal price, but they're not starting over. Does that make sense, Ryan? They're not having to start the piss process over. They're not starting the program and having, because you can't keep jumping around from platform to platform. You're not going to go from your iPhone to some other BlackBerry, back to an iPhone, back to this, back to that, over and over again, starting over. And that's what teams have been doing for years, chasing leads rather than building an ecosystem. This allows every team to build their ecosystem and maintain their ecosystem no matter what, and they can get it for a fraction of the cost.
Yeah, when I think about all the people set up on property alerts, you know, that a big team might have, you know, in whatever CRM you're using, and then you change platforms. I mean, how much GCI is lost just in reorganizing your contacts and getting them re-signed up?
Can we talk about that? Because there's a lot of teams listening in that have other platforms where they have 10,000 leads, and they're going, well, then why would I change from where I'm at now, right? The reality is because the system can't do, it does all that behavioral marketing, engagement, and nurture that you're not getting from the current systems. They don't have the auto responsiveness and the things that KV Core does, the behavioral responsiveness, the engagement. We tend to get about a 60% increase in lead engagement through our CRM over all the other platforms that teams might be using. That's without the agents logging in. So what happens is the alternative is you're not getting that, and you're dependent on the agents to follow up, which they're not going to do effectively. So then you have to go out and hire an ISA. So all about the smart CRM, the AI, the marketing autopilot, the automation of the program is all built to engage your leads into productive conversations and productive texting without your agents doing the work. So your agents can be more lead gen based, they're more powerful, to get people through your pipeline more effectively, to get more referrals. Everything's automated. So we have a process of moving the leads from their existing database into KV Core, and we have a concierge service, and they don't have to pay extra to have that done. So they export their leads into a CSV file, and our concierge service will update all of their agents' leads, and not just the leads from, say, a competitive platform like a Follow-Up Boss or some CRM. They will do it for the individual agents as well, and their sphere and their database. So we're able to import and follow a process to make what you just said, that's painful, easy.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah. So
no extra charge for that, Ryan.
Yeah, I know that import service is amazing, that it's free of charge. We had a question about the price. I figured that would come. Do you want to talk a little bit about the pricing of the add-on?
Sure. So the add-on price is $399 for up to 15 users on the team plan. And then we have a mega, like mega teams, and some of our competitors are recruiting brokers, and the brokers are moving the entire brokerage over of 30, 40 agents, which is typical. But those users, you know, you're in that $750 price point. Either way, it's a massive discount. The point is that those are the two options they have. There's no setup cost. That's one of the promotions that we do that Bert has. He has a coupon code for people that take part in the webinar. We do a lot of waiving of implementation or the concierge service. There's normally a fee for that. Bert has a coupon to give everybody listening in. And so if they call in or they come into the widget and book an appointment, so they actually book, they get access to a discount. So there is no setup cost. And it takes about anywhere from, 10 to 20 days to go live. The other thing that's important, Ryan, that we talk about transition and what I call change management, because they're doing a team add-on, rather than just get the broker dashboard, agent dashboard, and to kind of they have to kind of figure things out for themselves, Ryan, and take part of your trainings. It's important that when the team add-on process, if you order the team add-on and you participate in that, that you have a private go live engagement with our go live team. Yeah. And then after they go through that private go live engagement, they then are handed off to our team success coach that does a success in private coaching training process with their team. That is a much higher level than just getting the KV Core from the broker. So in other words, our teams find that super, super valuable. And again, there's no charge for that private training and private go live process. That's part of the team add-on.
Right. In a lot of cases, I mean, that the things you learn in that go live and in the success coaching process could be for the system when you really think about it. I know some of the coaches on that team, and they know a lot of stuff.
It speeds up the process. It just opens up that door. It's like, because like I said, it's them buying an actual platform. They're getting our system. If they called it KV Core and pay for it, that's what they would get. We don't treat the team add-on as a sub, category, we actually treat it as a real integration as though you bought the platform. That's important. It's a discount, but it's the full system.
Great. I'll just see if anybody here, does anybody have any questions about any of this in general, any feedback? We're here for you. Anything you want to talk about related to KV Core or any of our products and services? Let's see, anything else, Roberto or Brian, that we didn't touch upon here? I have a note here, recruit to the system was one idea. Maybe you could talk about that, Brian, how, you know, KV Core itself is a pretty good recruiting book.
It's a magnet. We get hundreds of calls a month from agents that want KV Core. And typically what happens is agents call in saying, I'd like to get KV Core. And the reason why, I'll give you an actual real life use case that will illustrate this point. I did a brokerage account, and there were agents for this particular broker that were part of a big old mastermind team group, because this broker happens to be part of LabCoats and has a big mega team of 20 agents, and we did it for his whole brokerage, and he's always on there. It's part of the whole ecosystem. And so this agent was on a private mastermind. I'm sure there's teams here that are part of those. And during the mastermind group, they talked about how the agents were like, oh my God, my broker's getting KV Core. I'm getting an independent system. We're getting all of this lead gen. We're getting this advertising. Well, Ryan, I was actually talking to a team that went to that mastermind group. They were going to buy a full system. When the agents talked on the mastermind group about KV Core, she was ready. She had a contract for her own independent private system because her broker didn't have KV Core. Her broker was with Compass. They didn't have the same technology. It was lacking. She actually quit Compass because of that webinar and went to work for that brokerage and brought her team over so she could get the platform for less money. The point I'm making is the KV Core is the magnet. Your agents on your team are your best advertisers. You can use the system like LeadGen, where you can create a hashtag, where you can load groups of agents into that as target audiences. You can create Facebook user groups, right, of agents. You can create landing pages and squeeze pages related to marketing to those agents, just like a buyer or a seller you would do. There's lots of options you can use the system to recruit agents to, and that would be maybe a training or a learning portal training that we talk about, Ryan, but no different than a buyer or seller. You use the same tactics, lunch and learns, KV Core Day, recruit from in the office, because the average agent doesn't have the willpower, the knowledge, or the money to necessarily market on Zillow or other tools. So there's a trend to do what I call co-ops. Consolidate into a team. And that's kind of a trend. And then team leaders want to support that. So that's something that is very powerful going on right now in the marketplace.
Awesome. A few other things here. I think I skipped over some bullets, but I think these are good points. You know, create team campaigns and ensure the right amount of engagement to the lead. So just make sure you have your own campaigns for lead follow-up. There's accountability settings to keep your agents accountable. And also, you have the ability to set tasks for individual team members. That's kind of a new feature. So if you have somebody who, say, always does transaction coordination, I don't know if it's a great example, but you could schedule a task and a follow-up plan that always goes to that person, whether or not the lead's assigned to them. And then once they complete the task, it reverts back to the agent who's assigned. So I guess bottom line is, those features are built in, and there's ways to use the system to get more efficient.
There's lots of things like webhooks and voicemail, like you click in videos and all these kind of things that really make this complex and ability. So we can be very robust for those high-level individuals that are high-tech savvy guys or have really high-level marketing departments as teams, or keep it simple. You know, we have campaigns already built in to do all that already. So the reality is that everybody's kind of – the one thing I can tell people is spending time and effort into trying to learn campaigns and do campaigns, when you have a behavioral marketing system that's auto following up, Ryan, is literally not worth the time and effort for most teams because of all the behavioral stuff we have.
That's good.
But the other thing that's important is teams should focus on actions and items. So in other words, a new lead you don't know anything about. So drip campaigns to a lead, new lead, is a waste of time. You have to find out what their intent is. So your campaign is really the initial campaign you run. Do behavioral marketing as well as your campaign is to gauge intent. Are they actually looking to buy a house? Most aren't. If you think about a market like San Diego, we probably get 100,000 searches a month. How many of those 100,000 are actually looking to buy a house right now, been qualified, have talked to a lender, and can buy a house and actually want to buy a house? Not very many when you think of the number of agents. There's far greater number of agents in the marketplace than there are the actual leads that want to really buy a house and can. So the reality is it's all about the long-term engagement, the long-term nurturing. The average lead 1 to 2 years away from buying when they start searching. So the reality of it is you better have something that's not going to annoy people.
Yep.
So you better think about that.
I brought up on the screen, you make a good point about marketing autopilot, not getting bogged down in the minutiae of the marketing automation. I mean, there are things like just setting up search alerts, letting the behavioral stuff do its thing that makes this really simple. So.
Yeah, you know, I have a really good analogy that I think the teams can take away from this that will really be helpful for everybody listening in. And I like to say that it's like you're creating a restaurant and you have a menu, and everybody in the marketplace has a restaurant. Every team member, team agent has a team website. It's like a restaurant. Every person on that team has their own sub restaurant. Every broker has a restaurant. Zillow has a restaurant, but the consumer that's consuming is eating the same food, meaning the property. They're eating pictures of houses. They're not eating the name of the realtor. They're out consuming the properties. They're consuming market reports. They're not consuming REMAX. That's not what they consume. So the menu is the same. Does that make sense, Ryan?
Yeah. Yeah.
So the only thing that we can do as realtors is we're waiters. All we can do is say, would you like more information about this home? Would you like another Diet Coke? And we can send them new menu items on a daily basis. But what you don't want to do is sit there and drop a flyer or some promotion on your waiter and how smart they are, and they're on their table every 5 minutes. That doesn't work. That's antiquated. You're consuming the food. And so the best way to look at it, until you know their intent to buy, you have to ask them questions. Would you like this? Would you like that? That's impossible, Ryan. And that's where the behavior comes in. Is, hey, Julie, did you look up this property and have any questions about it? Let me know. Bob, the system makes the agent look like a virtual waiter helping the consumer with what they have and what they're looking at and what they're consuming automatically. A human being cannot do that effectively in the space. Just so, can't happen.
So we had a question. Randy asked, you mentioned AI integration. Where do I find it as a texting base? So if you go into Marketing Autopilot, you'll see a tab for behavioral automation. And you have some switches you can turn off and on. You can turn it off or on for specific statuses. You can take a look at the emails and texts that are going out. Randy asked if there were texts as well, and there are.
Right? Yeah. We get a really high level response rate, Randy. And what you want to know is it's important that that's a great question. It always fouls people up. If you're working with somebody and you gauge intent, you don't want the system to be texting them when they're in your car. The reality is it's people that you've never talked to, your dead leads, people on alerts, people that you aren't following up, new leads, the whole point. But once that person's made a client, you can turn it off. So you're working with that person or your sphere of influence. Maybe you don't want AI on for that. So it's the ability is there. One thing I will point out in the testimonials I get, Ryan, on this, we had a team leader of mine that was using the system. She was at the grocery store and a lead came up to her in the aisle and introduced themselves. Said it was really great. Thanks for following up. You're a great agent. She had no idea who she was, but the lead was getting text messages and the system was behaviorally following up that the person recognized her in the actual grocery store, out in real life. She was shocked.
Yeah, that's really cool. Well, Brian, I'm sorry to do this, but I actually have a very important thing to do in about 7 minutes. If anybody has any questions, I'm going to let people give some questions now. I'll let you and Roberto, if you want to just bring up any additional points here. For the last few minutes while we wait for questions. But I think this has been useful,
Absolutely. Ryan, it's really helpful for this. It doesn't hurt to click on the book a demo with Roberto, because not knowing and not understanding and not getting a private tour of this, it's like saying, I want to run my team, or I'm not trying to be critical of anybody, but I'm investigating another product and it's really a Walkman and we have an iPhone. without knowing what you're missing out on, without really taking at least a look, a little private tour, 80 to 85% of the people that take a tour as a team leader, they click on the core team out, they book in and do a quality engagement with Roberto, and he actually goes through and answers their questions one on one. Over 80% of the people get the team out on, Brian. So the reality is, it doesn't hurt you to find out. You're going to learn something. He's going to go through your team. He's going to give you some information. He's going to answer your questions. It's almost like a coaching call. And chances are you'll make a decision that's good for your business. But the point is not finding out the details. I mean, why not? It's, you know, 30-minute call, no time off your back. It's worth doing.
So somebody's asking for contact info for additional questions. Katrina, you can either use the book a demo, or I sent you Roberto's email address. I think it's rlara at Insight, right, Roberto?
Yeah, if you click book a demo right there, go ahead and just give it a click, and then you'll see that my information is right on the page that comes up, as well as and the ability to just book right into a time slot in my calendar.
Great.
And it's really easy. But that's my direct phone that'll call me. That's my email address. You'll get me. That's our main website that won't get me, but booking right here will. And I just want to emphasize this before we let everybody go that my whole job here is just to help you understand this tool and just make sure it makes sense for what your goals are. There's some teams where it's not necessary in some respects, and that's kind of one-offs, but if that's the case, that's the case. But for the most part, this is the glue that's going to help tie everything together, give you complete visibility over your business as a team, and give you the administrative tools that you need to make everybody work cohesively together. And it's really, really powerful. So we can kind of get into the weeds there and then, you know, get the ball rolling if that's direction they want to go. I'm also very familiar with my competition. Like I said, been in the space for 16 years. Whether it's Boomtown, Commissions Inc., or even some of the other systems out there, I'm familiar with them and can give you a fairly, maybe a little bit biased, but as unbiased as I can, understanding of how they stack up.
Cool. So, thank you everybody for being on. Thanks, Roberto. We're going to get this replay live and sent out to everybody within a few hours. Again, if you need Roberto or Brian, it's rlara at Inside Real Estate. You can use the book a demo. And that's about it. Thank you everybody for watching.
Thanks everyone.
Thank you, Brian. Thank you, Roberto. Thanks, Annalisa.
See you guys next week.
Bye.
Bye.